Why? Hello, friends. It's Paulshinn, and welcome back to what is probably the boomerest car channel on all of YouTube. So here I am in the Model A with somewhere to go, and the Model A doesn't want to start. Obviously, it's been hanging around my dad and taking stubborn lessons again. So what do you do to figure out why your Model A won't start? This video is going to be all about basic troubleshooting steps to figure out why your Model A isn't going to start, why you're stranded on the side of the road. This isn't an all-encompassing video. It's just the quick things that you check to get back on the road in a hurry. So obviously my Model A is not starting. Well, it's cranking, so I have power. Obviously the battery works. But the question is, do I have power to the rest of the car? Especially if you have one of the starter-mounted fuse holders. Well, it's real easy to check that too. So from here inside the car, all I have to do is turn on the headlights or even honk the horn. Well, since they both work in my car here, obviously I have power to the rest of the car so the fuse isn't blown. You can also tell by cranking the car. When you're cranking with the ignition on, you should see the ammeter moving a little bit back and forth. The whole electrical draw is probably maybe 3 amps on the coil and everything, so it doesn't move a lot, but it'll wiggle a little. So since I have that, obviously I have something else going on. So what do you need in order to make an engine run? Well, you need air, gas, and spark, right? Okay, well, let's figure out which one I'm missing. So welcome back to my shop, where safety is the highest priority. Here we go. So now when I say I was raised in the hood, you know what I'm talking about. Time to lift the hood, find out what's going on. Remember, we need 3 things in order to make a motor run. We need spark, gas, and air. So the first thing I'm going to check, air. Is anything blocking the air intake of the carburetor? Well, I run a K&N filter on most of my Model A's, at least the ones that get driven, especially almost every day like this one. And there's no obstruction here in this filter, and I recently cleaned this. And I'm just going to check and make sure that the choke mechanism works. Make sure that's not stuck, so there's nothing blocking the air intake to the carburetor. So I'm going to call that one good. The next thing we're going to have to check is gas. Are we getting gas? So with the gas valve shut off, grab your 9/16 wrench, or if you have the cheapo reproduction fittings, then you'll need a 1/2 inch wrench. You might get a few drips out of here. It shouldn't be gushing out of here because the gas valve is shut off. Assuming your fuel is actually flowing. Okay, now I'm going to get a gas can. I'm going to put it underneath this. And then I'm going to go turn the gas valve on. I'm going to see if I've got fuel flow. Oh, yeah. Oh yeah, plenty of fuel flow. So that's a check. We're getting fuel to the carburetor. Now, you should have a really decent flow. It shouldn't need like a, you know, flow max or anything. It should be a really steady flow of fuel coming out of it. Darn near gushing. If you let it run for a little while, if you have a gas cap that's not venting properly, you'll see it begin to slow down, and then you can release the gas cap and actually kind of hear it go an inhale if the gas cap needs to be vented better. But I've got plenty of fuel flow on this, so that is clearly not the issue. So what in the world is causing the problem here? Well, let's go to ignition. I need to know if I'm getting spark. For troubleshooting a Model A electrical system, you need to get a good analog voltmeter. Now, it doesn't have to be a Model A era almost correct Simpson like I have. You can get one of the inexpensive Radio Shack or Micronta, as it'll be called. As long as it's an analog, not a digital with little fancy digital thingies on it. You just want a little one of those. Anyway, this voltmeter here, the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to ground the positive side, because this is a 6-volt positive ground system, and with this set on the 10-volt scale, I'm going to see if I have voltage on each side of the coil, which I do. So the coil is not opened, so the coil is likely good, assuming that the coil makes spark. So we got to find that out. You can also test by looking at each side of these little wing nuts that are on your terminal box. You should be able to see voltage on those easily. So With that, I know for a fact now, I've got 6 volts going to my coil, and I know that the points are opening and closing because I saw the ammeter moving, but I'm still gonna look inside here because something is amiss. Okay, so now I've turned the key on inside the car, and armed with the information that I have 6 volts to the coil, I need to check and see if I'm getting 6 volts to my point. So that's easy enough to figure out. Pull this. Okay, now holding my points open with my finger, if I put the test lead on there, sure enough, I have 6 volts to my points. Okay, this is good, and this also corroborates what we were seeing on the ammeter with the ammeter moving. So we know the points are opening and closing and the points have voltage now. We just gotta figure out why we're not getting spark. Okay, so now I have rotated the motor in a position so that the distributor cam is holding the points open. So the key is on, the points are open. Now what I'm gonna do is take this lead here and I'm just gonna kind of put this somewhere near a nut on the head here. And I'm gonna take a screwdriver or anything metallic, really. I'm gonna short the points to ground. And look, every time I do, I'm hearing spark. I don't see the spark every time though, unusual. I hear the spark every time, but I don't see the spark every time. So let me stick my head in front of the camera, sorry. Oh, there's a little bit of sparking between this lead and the ignition cable here. So I probably have a bad spark lead. Let's figure that out. Oh, yes, there's been a little bit of arcing going on here, hasn't there? So apparently this lead, which has always been a little bit too long anyway, has made the path here along the ignition cable to the top of the distributor. It looks like occasionally it's jumping outside the jacket here and against the ignition cable. All right, well, that's easy enough to fix. I'll just throw a new one of these on, but only this time I'll get the correct length so that it's not rubbing on anything. All right, new ignition coil wire. I use the ones with the boots on the ends. That's not stock originally from the factory. They did not have the rubber boots on the ends, obviously. I just like them because they make me feel better. All right, let's check this one. Let's see how this one works. Oh. Yes, it sparks to the head nut every time now. All right, perfect. All right, let's put this beast back together and see what happens. Well, there you go. That'll get you going about 90% of the time. So I hope this was a helpful video for you. Please subscribe. Click the little subscribe button right down there. Huge thanks going out to Perry Wilson for sending a donation. Thank you so much, Perry. Appreciate it. Bill Mueller, appreciate your donation. Also, Leslie Vrabel. Thank you, Leslie, for sending your donation. It's people like you that really help this channel go. Special huge thanks to Mark Limmer. Huge donation. We're going to finish Athena, finally, thanks to that. Also, Ben Evans and Replications Company for your monthly donations. Thank you so much. I'll catch you on the next video.